This is a production of WKNO Memphis. Production funding for this program is made possible in part by the WKNO Production Fund, the WKNO Endowment Fund, and by viewers like you. Thank you.
Mamie Shannon, welcome to Local Color. I'm so excited I've got my divas. All my garden divas are around me today. And you know what? We have not eaten anywhere in a long time. We need to go somewhere. Where do you want to go? We've had chicken. We've had barbecue. We've had burgers.
Mexican.
Yes.
Let's do that.
Okay, so y'all stay tuned because we're going to go eat some Mexican and let you see us with our mouths full. I can't wait. We'll have to talk about that.
Yeah. Hopefully it'll make them want to go out and not go, look at them making a pig out of themselves.
Did those girls leave anything at the Mexican restaurants in town?
Oh, no.
Well, coming up, I'm really excited about this. One of my favorite plays of all time is Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf? Hattaloo's doing it. So George and Martha and their little dysfunctional relationship, you know, they like to get together for some cocktails and... And they invite this poor young couple over, and the young couple are like, what in the heck have we stepped into? So I can't wait to see this production. It's August the 30th through September the 16th at Hattaloo, and I think it's going to be a great time. So please go out and support Hattaloo and see Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf.
Well, also, you know, something that's coming up that's a chance to see a classic, that would be Neil Young.
He is a classic.
They're doing a showing at Studio on the Square on August 31st, and it's Neil Young Journeys.
Oh, this is his documentary.
It's a documentary. It's done by Jonathan Demme, who is a well-known Hollywood director and has done, you know, tons of great movies and everything. And so it's two concerts in Toronto. You get a chance to see Neil backstage talking, you know, about his career and how he started out and now versus then and everything and the things he's learned along the way. I will add to that that I've had this new... I do still see Neil Young as a cratchety old man, but one of the things that may come out of his cratchiness is he is determined to find to do a patent for a new really, I guess, tool for delivering music. Everybody uses MP3s, and you know through the MP3 process, it's sort of squished.
Yeah.
You know, they sort of squish the sound just to make it all work. And so he is determined that that does not sound good. That's not how you're supposed to listen to music. How can we figure out how to give you the fullness that you're supposed to hear in music and do it through another process?
And so not make it so sanitized.
10 years from now, Neil Young will have us and we'll be on iTunes downloading this new format of music that sounds super cool and full, like when you listen to a record.
Or we'll just have a chip in our brains and then we can think of a song and just download it right there.
No, because
music
is meant to be shared.
That's it.
But until then, we can see Neil Young in Journeys, and it's one of those things that Memphis is, you can't see it anywhere else yet, so you need to go check it out, and we'll be talking about it. You know, there's select cities that are doing the showing, so we'll be talking about it before everybody else, and I always love that.
Yeah, I do too, because we're such trendsetters.
That's right.
Speaking of trendsetters, what's the next concert at Live at the Garden?
Live at the Garden. So, okay, I have to admit that this one was a shocker for me.
Because I'm proud of them.
Lynard Skynard is playing Live at the Garden. And when you think Live at the Garden, you think classy. You think, oh, what kind of environment are we going to be in? We'll be at the Garden, darling. You know? And then you put Lynard Skynard with that, and it's just like, interesting.
They should call this one Gritty at the Garden.
Gritty at the Garden, yeah. And it's going to be fun. Lynyrd Skynyrd always puts on a great show. I know that people would be shocked to know that I'm a Skynyrd fan, but if you had seen me watching the behind the music on Lynyrd Skynyrd like 15 years ago, and someone called me in the middle, and I was like, I can't talk right now. They're at the plane crash. I'm in tears. You know, I really do appreciate some Skynyrd.
My first ever concert I paid for as a 12-year-old.
It's
it was
great
Steve Miller Band and Lynard Skynyrd.
That's awesome.
And
that's
I'm a Yankee.
And you know what is going to be so cool? Somebody's going to yell Free Bird.
Oh, somebody. And they will, for once, they will get their wish. It will be played.
Pack your lighter.
Yes. So I think it's going to be a great show for people who don't think they like Lynard Skynard.
Yeah.
Can go. They're going to know some songs. And it's really the Southern rock.
They are so
tradition
high energy,
is just,
and
so,
it's going to be a
yeah,
great show.
It's a great show.
So. Well, and another thing that's going to be a great show, how cool is it? Back up. Lynard Skynard is the 31st.
The 31st,
the
yes.
The 31st. And guys, don't feel like you have to write all this stuff down. You can go to wkno.org/localcolor, and we will have everything listed for you with a link to the website, with the time, date, place, and everything. So just sit back and enjoy, because, Denny, I am so excited about Cochon 555 and, again, Memphis being selected for the special event that's coming up.
This is huge for Memphis. There is so much going on in the culinary world in Memphis, and we are just exploding right now on a national scene. And this is part of that. The Cochon 555 competition, which was here in February, which Kelly English won and then went on to compete in Aspen, the organization that runs that enjoyed their experience in Memphis so much that they have created a brand new event that they are bringing to Memphis Labor Day weekend. It's called the Cochon Heritage BBQ. They're bringing chefs from all around the country, Boston, Denver, Lexington, Atlanta, Memphis, to compete and utilize heritage pork, heritage pigs, to cook barbecue in Home of Barbecue here in Memphis.
How cool is that?
There are events going on all weekend, and we'll talk about them a little bit later, but there's so much going on. That Friday night, to start it off, they're doing a mixologist soiree on top of the Peabody, which is fantastic. That's from 7 to 10. There's also, in the middle of that, going to be a heritage bologna contest.
I love that.
Get your bologna on.
Get your barbecued bologna.
And Denny, will you talk about, I mean, this is huge for foodies in Memphis. You know, we're known for music around the world, but, you know, there are so many things now that it's like the food portion of things, our hiking trails, known as a natural city and everything. But the thing that I found interesting is that when you say heritage pork, it really doesn't register that it like blows your mind how good it is.
Yeah.
Right. And we're not talking, when they talk about heritage pork, they're talking about, pigs that are specific to America that have been hand raised. Like if you think Newman Farms, if you go to the farmer's market here, you can get Newman Farms pork. They're from Myrtle, Missouri. Their pigs are raised in this wonderful manner. They wander around and eat acorns in the woods, and they're these beautiful, lovely pigs. They taste entirely different than a commercially raised pig. And that's what this organization that puts on this event tries to bring awareness to, that there are these wonderful little family-owned farms that raise these pigs that you can do some amazing things with.
Well, and they do go from snout to tail on this, in this event.
They sure do. We've got the bologna thing that night. And then don't forget, another thing that they're celebrating with this, in addition to pig,
is
bourbon. It's National Bourbon Month. The National Bourbon Organization is kicking off National Bourbon Month in Memphis, which I think is highly appropriate since football's kicking off that weekend.
What's better than barbecue in Memphis? Barbecue and bourbon.
Right. Yep. So that night at the Peabody, Friday night, if you missed the earlier events, go to the Peabody from 10:30 until 1:30 or 10 to 1:30, and there is a midnight bourbon tasting. You think New Year's, but with bourbon instead of champagne.
And, you know, this is the time of year. The spring and the fall are my favorite times in Memphis. As an event producer, I love special events. And we have so many festivals, so many fairs, so many events that are going on. We have so much to cover. Delta Fair coming up.
Delta Fair.
Love Delta Fair.
The Delta Fair. Fun times. I mean, not only do you have rides, do you have Pronto Pups. Oh, I can't wait to have
it. I can't
wait
either.
It's the one time a year I have a Pronto Pup. I just allow it. And yes, funnel cakes and all that fun, but the Delta Fair also has great music. I think that it's fun this year that two of the acts are a blast from the past. The Marshall Tucker Band, speaking of Southern Rock, and Flock of Seagulls, which my hair was a Flock of Seagulls inspiration.
I was going to say, is that an homage?
Yes, yes. We've also got a lot of local bands playing, like Deering and Down, the Owen Sisters, a band I was telling you guys about earlier. It's four sisters, and they are a vocal gymnastics experience, okay? Everyone has talked about how sweet their sound is, and just I'm so excited to go see them at the Delta Fair this year that I was just like, they've gone out of their way to make sure there are more local acts, that they found acts that you don't see everywhere, and you know, we were joking earlier, everybody's playing the Delta Fair, so whenever you go, you're going to find good music. It's a fun family event, and it's at the Agri Center, so it starts on the 31st, and you've got plenty of time to go over there and get your fair on.
Yeah.
Deep fried Snickers. Yeah.
Yes.
Everything deep fried.
Well, and just to point out, you hit on it, Pronto Pups are completely different than corn dogs.
Yes.
So do not confuse the two. Pronto
Specialists
Pups.
Specialists would know that.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Andrini's, for the Pronto Pups. And you know, there's some new things going on at the Delta Fair.
Yes, there's, what's it called, the Sugar Arts Competition. And this is brand new. This is the first year they're doing it. And when I first heard about this, I was thinking the, like, kind of the rock candy stuff, the hard sugar stuff. But no, this is like cupcakes and cakes and every possible way that sugar can be utilized and all the decorating. And so you can go and see, what is it, over 280 people setting up here, exhibitors setting up, and just kind of check out the sugary snacks.
They have dedicated an entire wing in the Agri Center to the Sugar Arts Competition. And it's not, you know, one end of the spectrum or the other. It's all levels of expertise. And 280 exhibitors or something like that. Mm-hmm. They're also going to, as a nod to the Mid-South, they're going to be giving exhibits on how to make a hound dog cake. Mm-hmm. You know, they're giving demonstrations. There are cooking classes. There are folks there that are selling all the stuff that you need to become a sugar artist yourself. And it's presented by the West Tennessee Sugar Arts Association, which is pretty cool.
That is. It's
and I'm really excited.
Do you get to taste anything?
I think it would be very cruel if you didn't.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's time to loosen your belt.
We'll have
it's time to go to the cafe.
Yeah. Hey, next year maybe we could be a judge.
Oh, yeah. That would be great.
Yes. I'll put my name in the hat.
I'll do that.
When you get too much, do you wash your mouth with milk and just go to the next?
No.
I need to cleanse my palate.
Sugar.
So, de-glaze. Answer this question. When you get too full, what do you wash your mouth out with?
Beer. Absolutely beer. And one of the best beer events is coming up in the city. And this is the chance for you as an adult to go to the zoo and leave your kids at home. This is Zoo Brew is coming up on August 31st from 7 to 10. It is a very popular event that the zoo puts on. It is 21 and up. So
yes.
Make sure that...
Leave the kitties at home.
Leave the kitties at home. They are going to have live music. It's an evening event, so you get to see the zoo at night. And if you've never been to the zoo at
night... It's magical.
It is magical. It's so neat. It's beautiful. There's going to be stations everywhere. There's great beers this year. They're kind of doing an around-the-world theme, so they've got it kind of grouped by country. And some of my favorites that are coming up that I cannot wait to taste are the Ale Mary Winter Ale. Because that just sounds good. This is another one that I have tasted. They have Dead Guy Rogue, which is just, you know,
that's
perfect. And it's one of my favorites, too. Mm-hmm. Perfect in time for Halloween and everything.
Well, and, you know, just as we talked about on the wine tasting show, this is another way that you can go out without spending a whole lot of money or a whole lot of effort to go to different venues to try these craftsmen's beers and try them in one venue.
Right. Yeah,
and,
right.
You know, compare and you know, make yourself
some,
aware.
Yeah, beer drinking is quite the experience.
It really is.
You know, and you look at instead of looking at the legs, you're looking at the skirt. I mean, it's just like the experience is pretty, you know, to know and taste the difference. It's pretty fabulous. And you can get all of it in one night and figure out, I want to try a new beer. And I really like this.
And you can check out the beers that they're going to have on their website. They have a map already set up, and they've really gone out of their way this year to present a diverse grouping of beer and a lot of craft beers, which are so, so hot right now. If you do go, I would recommend getting together with a group of friends, taking a cab there and taking a cab back, because it is pretty much all you can drink.
Yeah, because if you just taste a few, then you
next
know,
thing you know.
There is food there, but I would recommend doing that. And they're also doing a special thing this year in the Teton Trek building, which is just beautiful.
It's gorgeous.
If you haven't been there, you can buy a special VIP ticket, which gets you extra back access to some extra special beers and some of the more diverse beers. So
and I like that you brought up the website where they have a list of beers. Mm-hmm. I've made the rookie mistake before of going in and just hitting all the front tents.
Yeah.
And at the very end, discovering there's all, I mean, it goes on forever. So one of the things we like to do is go start at the back and kind of work our way. Do your homework before so you don't, you know, blow it all.
Get overwhelmed.
Right.
Speaking of overwhelming, the Center for Southern Folklore has really gone above and beyond this year.
Yes, it's Heritage Fest time again. Yay! It is by far one of my favorite events in the city. And I go to a lot of events. You know, we all go to a lot of events. And it is the shining star as a music fan. As a fan of Southern culture, there's food. They have a cooking demonstration stage this year. You can watch a Cherokee basket weaver work and create this piece of work that's been passed down generation to generation. And then you can, next to that person, there may be a pottery artist who's just spinning pottery. And then you've got all this great music throughout.
Right.
You know, we've got some great acts playing this year. I was not aware, but Denny pointed out to me that this year was dedicated to Billy Lee Riley, an amazing, amazing boy from Arkansas who made Rockabilly Hot. And he was a fabulous guy, one of the, you know, nicest people I've ever met. And so it's all dedicated to him this year.
And he just passed away. He was a huge supporter of the
festival. And he loved to play. And we've got, you know, this year I jokingly said, is Bobby Rush playing? But there's no Bobby Rush. But we've got the queen of the Chitlin' Circuit, Miss Denise LaSalle, playing. And so Denise LaSalle, well.
And you know, if you've ever seen Bobby Rush, you know, people might be disappointed that Bobby Rush and his dancers won't be there. I have it on good authority from my own very eyes that Denise LaSalle is even dirtier than Bobby Rush.
Yeah.
It's
raunchy fun.
That's intense.
Oh,
snap.
I mean, she's just like.
And this year, it's really cool because it goes all the way from Union down to Peabody Place.
Right.
They've expanded
all
it.
On Main Street.
Main Street, right.
And, you know, not just because you're sitting here and you're my girlfriend, but, you know, if you've never been down there, shame on you, number one. Sit at the Majestic Patio. It's a great place to people watch. You're right in the middle of everything, and it's just a lovely place to stroll.
And I'll also point out that it's one of those things that you go during the earlier in the day, take your kids, everything's free.
Right.
You know, they do donations,
and
you
then
know,
you drop
everything.
Them off at grandma's and go back.
Yeah, and then
runs
you go back.
11.
We go have lunch there, take our daughter, have lunch, have a great time, and then we'll go back at night. And it is, there's something for everyone there. It's not just music.
That's
They'll
it.
Have Ballet Memphis is performing.
That's it.
Subculture Royalty is performing. So they've got all these arts groups also. So it's just everything Southern. It's right there. So I suggest that everyone, don't miss it again.
Absolutely.
If you've never been, don't miss it again.
Absolutely.
Well, coming up this weekend is also football season.
Oh, it is.
Kicking it off. So, the Memphis Tigers are kicking it off against UT Martin this Saturday at 6 p.m. at the Liberty Bowl. And, of course, Tiger Lane is beautiful.
It really is.
It's one of my most favorite times of the year because of all the food and the festivities and the football, of course. So I'm really looking forward to this.
So go out and support your Tigers.
That's right. And I don't know, have y'all seen the new ad campaign, the Mind Your Business Dentist commercials? If you
I
haven't, they're hilarious.
You know, I wish that someone, that the University of Memphis would send out a rogue camera crew, man on the street kind of thing, and go to karaoke around the city and see if there was any doubt if this was a Tiger Town.
Yeah.
Let them play Eye of the Tiger
and
watch the whole karaoke room just go into this emotive, explosive Eye of the Tiger. I mean, everyone
with hand
singing.
Gestures. I mean, like with the hand gestures and everything.
Yes. They should totally capture that. It's
I think
amazing
that would be a great commercial. I think that would be great.
That would be hilarious. Well, you can, if you don't tailgate at Tiger Lane, which you should, you can go out Saturday and as part of the Cochon Heritage BBQ Festival, a whole group of restaurants, barbecue restaurants in Memphis, are going to be offering barbecue plates for $5.55.
Perfect.
Perfect. Pre-football.
This is Saturday.
Saturday. You can go to their website, heritagebarbecue.com, or our website, Local Color, and check it out. There's also some other things going on. Now, if you want to get slightly athletic on Saturday, you can do the Cochon 555K, which is in Cooper Young. That is going to be at 9:30, and you race around Cooper Young, and I have heard a rumor that there will be bourbon tastings throughout the race. So you can...
That is a recipe for amazing.
It would definitely be more of a stroll than a run.
Talk about some pulled pork.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. That can all end up, and it actually goes on simultaneously. If you don't want to run, but you still want to hang out and have a good time, there's going to be an heirloom Bloody Mary tailgate with Alan Benton, the Tennessee gem of a pig master. He does wonderful smoked bacon and smoked meats. He's just an absolute legend. He is going to be hosting this heirloom Bloody Mary tailgate at Sweetgrass in the Bank of America parking lot right next to Sweetgrass there from 9:30 to 11. That's again part of the Cochon Heritage Barbecue stuff. And then that night at Sweetgrass, they're going to do two seatings for a pop-up restaurant. A lot of the chefs that are going to be in for the barbecue competition are just going to kind of cook, and you can come in.
Oh, that sounds like so much fun.
Yeah. So there's tons of stuff going on Saturday, too, if you can't get to the Friday or Sunday events.
I don't even know what to do this weekend now. I feel like I have so many choices that I need. I'm going to have to plan everything out just so I can hit more than one.
I know.
That's right.
Got to pull out our day timers.
Yes. Yes.
Well, tell me about this new book you were talking about.
Okay, this comes out in late September, and I was going to ask if y'all are tired of pork. I know you're not, but this is sushi related, and this is a local chef, and she is the first African-American sushi, first certified African-American sushi chef, that's hard to say,
yes,
in the U.S. And the book is called Sushi
Secrets.
Thanks. Easy recipes for the home cook. And this is Marissa Baggett. This will come out in late September. And I'm really looking forward to this.
I am too.
Marissa is so much fun. And find her, you can find her on Facebook or whatever, but she is just like, she makes you like think of sushi as just like, I mean, you know how when you have somebody who loves their craft,
yeah,
they love what they do, they get you excited about it. And she's one of those people. She even, you know, has offered to do like little sushi classes. You know, if you get a small group of people together, you can get your girls together and do a girls' night and learn how to make something as far as sushi goes and pick up a new skill. You know,
She's all official. We're all sitting here thinking maybe that would be a fun segment on the show.
Mm-hmm. That would be nice.
Absolutely.
Incredibly intimidating to me, but I think this book is going to rein it in a little bit.
To find somebody that could make it fun and demystify it would be cool. You know, every year I look for new talent, and I love stand-up. You were telling me about Ralphie May.
Ralphie May is, I love to watch him on Comedy Central. He's one of the, when I see his name, I'll stop just to watch it. And just because he's funny and he's lovable, he's a Tennessee boy. He's from Chattanooga. And he lives around the Nashville area, but I'm sure that in the process of him talking about his family and all the things he goes through, you know, there are some things that we share as Southerners, you know, how all of our families are just, it's the same story. You just change the name.
Right.
And, and so he's just a funny guy, and he's coming to town. And it's going to, I think that the show itself is going to be one of those things where you're just laughing in your seat.
I think so, too. He's an everyman, and his take on life is, you know, now that you've told me he's from Tennessee, it almost makes sense.
It makes sense, yeah. He's from Chattanooga, too.
Yes.
You know, they think a little different.
Yes. Well, you know, people in our part.
Yeah, they have those mountains around them.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, every Thursday in September, this is a cool free event. You know how I love my free things. Every Thursday in September, there's the Hootenannies at Old Town in Olive Branch. It's Thursday night. Go take your lawn chair. Go take your grandkids. Hang out in Pigeon Roost Plaza Park. And listen to these guys play. And that sounds like a fun thing. So what are you doing this weekend?
Well, I'm everything. I'm going to hit the on Sunday. It's the real competition for the Cochon Heritage.
And that sounds like a hot thing to do.
That is going to be amazing.
And now, where is the competition going to be?
That's going to be at the Columns, which
is... Oh, I love that building. Mm-hmm,
which is in the Commerce Square building. So it's right downtown. They're going to take over Main Street and put a big market out there. So you can hit the Center for Southern Folklore Festival, walk down the street. Downtown is going to be
It's going to be awesome this weekend.
Yeah, downtown's going to be crazy. Friday night, it also is Trolley tour.
That's right.
You've got
That's
trolley
right.
tour going on. You've got Gone with the Wind at the Orpheum. I mean, it's going to be a great time to be downtown. So you should just come on into town if you live outside of town. If you live on the outskirts of town, you just come on in and make it a night. Because
so,
I think
look,
you'll be occupied.
The trolley tour starts at like 6, right?
6 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. So you can go down, start on the south end, hit the trolley tour,
get some free wine.
Right, right. Get some free wine and then move right on up the street. Go catch Gone with the Wind. It's like 7.
Yep.
7:30 or something
yeah,
like that at the Orpheum.
Though, so.
And then hop in the cab, go to the zoo.
Yep.
Hit the zoo brew. And then hop in that cab and come right back downtown.
For the midnight bourbon tasting.
For the midnight bourbon tasting.
Wow.
Oh, my gosh. So we're not going to go to bed from Friday afternoon until
That's right.
Sunday, Sunday night.
That's why we all have off on Monday. So we can just sleep.
So we can recover. Yeah. From the barbecue bourbon beer hangover.
Wow. Bliss. I would like to say bliss.
The BBB hangover, definitely.
And then we could go to the Delta Fair on Sunday.
Oh, gosh. Everything deep fried and sweet.
Oh,
amazing.
And you know, that's what you need after bourbon.
After bourbon, yeah.
That's right.
You need some Pronto Pups and everything sweet and deep fried.
Yeah.
I wonder if they're going to have those Oreos.
Or you could put together, actually, this weekend's such a good weekend, you could put together your own little trek. You could do the, like, you could do your Southern Rock trek. You could have you could have Lynard Skynard, then you could go have a bourbon, then you could go to the Delta Fair.
Don't forget the bologna on top of the
That's
you know,
right.
You could
That's
have
right.
a barbecue trek, and you could do barbecue mm-hmm. all along the way. You could do
arts.
Yes.
And do trolley night.
That's it.
And then you do the art at
you could do sports.
Center
you could do the game, and then go run in the 5-5-5K.
5-5-5 and uh-huh. have some bourbon while you're running.
You know what? You're out of time.
There's
I'm
no,
sorry.
Can't stay home
We're
this
having
week.
Way too much fun planning our weekend. You guys come back next week because we have a ton for you next week as well. You know, we're in the middle of it. So come back next week and enjoy your local color. And if you don't get out, it's your fault.